Hi there, I'm Sam Yeaman. I'm a researcher at the University of British Columbia, and I'm here today to answer a question about DNA tests. Someone asked, I've seen ads for personal DNA kits you can order and test your DNA. Do they really work? Well, the short answer is yes, they do work. There's been lots of money put into developing these kits, but what you probably want to know is how do they work and what can I use them for? Broadly, there's two main things that people use DNA tests for. What you may have heard about for a long time is things like DNA fingerprinting, where they use 10 to 20 markers that aren't really associated with anything interesting, but just are kind of like a unique fingerprint to actually identify a given individual. And this is used sometimes in criminal investigations or in paternity testing. And by getting enough markers that vary among different individuals, you can get a unique signature of which individual is which and whether they're likely to be related to somebody else. But these simple tests don't tell us very much that's biologically interesting. Newer versions of DNA testing using single nucleotide polymorphisms, so single base pair changes in the genetic code, are much more useful. These modern tests by companies like 23andMe will assay hundreds of thousands to millions of different variants across your entire genome. And they'll be able to tell you, using this information, whether you have simple characteristics, simple traits, like things like whether you like the taste of cilantro, what kind of earwax you have, and whether you're lactose tolerant, some things that you might already know about your phenotype. They can also tell you things you may not know, such as your susceptibility to certain medical problems, such as heart disease or cancer. Now, these are really interesting developments, and a lot of genetics is still being done and trying to understand how complex traits like this that matter to us actually work, but we're getting part of the way. And this is what's important to understand about genetic testing, is they can't tell you perfectly what's going to happen, but they can give you an indication of the probability of developing certain kinds of conditions. Now, there's some ethical problems, implications with this kind of thing, because you may not want to know this. You may not want to feel like you've got something hanging over your head and knowing that maybe this is going to shorten your lifespan. On the other hand, though, if it's something where you can actually be proactive and make lifestyle choices that might reduce the chance of having a problem, then this could be really beneficial in the long run. Another really interesting thing about 23andMe and other similar genetic tests is that they give you information about your ancestry. Because we share parts of our genome with people that are closely related to us, and we share less with people that are further related to us, they can reconstruct based on similarity of your genome to other people across the world. They can make guesses about where your ancestry came from. This is really neat because sometimes you can even get an estimation of how much of your genome actually is derived from, say, Neanderthal DNA. And this is something that's included in some of the platforms such as 23andMe. Now, it's also important to think about the fact that when you get your DNA genotyped, you may not have complete control over it. Privacy is an issue that's important with DNA testing, and when you send off your DNA to get it typed, that information is going to be sitting somewhere that's not inside of your body. And in some countries, this is more of a problem where there may be less security around these kinds of things, but it's something to be aware of. So I guess the take-home message that I'd like to say is that DNA testing kits are really exciting. They can give you some very fascinating information, but we still have a long way to go in terms of understanding what makes us the way we are, and we do want to think about the ethical implications of this kind of thing. Thanks, and hope you enjoyed this.